This is the story of Deborah and what we learn from her life. The Israelites were God's special people. He loved them and saved them many a time. He brought them out of Egypt with a mighty hand and many miracles. But the Israelites soon forgot that and turned to wicked ways. They did evil in the Lord's sight, and so he gave them into the hands of Jabin. Jabin was the king of Canaan, and the leader of the Canaanite army was Sisera. They had a strong army and 900 iron chariots. They burdened the Israelites for 20 long years. At last, the Israelites repent from their sins, ask God for his forgiveness, and come back to him. They cry out to him, and he gives them a mighty prophetess by the name Deborah. She was the wife of Lapidoth, and she soon became the leader of Israel. She wasn't just a leader, she was a judge too. She held court under a palm tree. It was called the Palm of Deborah, and it was between Ramah and Bethel. The Israelites used to bring their fights to her, and she used to bring peace among the community. One day, she asked for Barak, who was the son of Abinoam. When he arrived, this is what she said: "The Lord tells you to go with 10,000 men from the tribes of Naphtali and Zebulun to battle. Lead your men to Mount Tabor, and the Lord will bring Sisera and his army to the Kishon River." He says, "Deborah, only if you go with me I will go, but if you don't, I won't go either." Deborah quickly replies, "I will go with you." She encourages her friend. So Barak and his army march to Mount Tabor, and as soon as Sisera gets to know about this, he leads his army to the Kishon River. When Barak hears of this, Deborah encourages him, "Go, this is the day the Lord has given Sisera into your hands. Has not the Lord gone ahead of you?" Barak is encouraged. Even the stars of the sky fight for Israel against Sisera and his army. As Barak started attacking the enemy, the Lord threw Sisera and his entire army into confusion. His entire army was killed, and Sisera tried to save his own life by running on foot. He reaches the tent of Heber, who was the king's ally. So he thought he could be safe there. There he meets Jael, and she says that she will hide him under a blanket. When Sisera asks for water, Jael gives him milk for his thirst. And as Sisera was sleeping, Jael puts a tent peg through his forehead and kills him. As Barak searches for Sisera, he reaches the tent of Jael too. Jael tells him that Sisera is dead. The Israelites grew stronger from that day, and eventually they win over King Jabin too. In Judges chapter 5, Deborah and Barak sing a beautiful song to the Lord, celebrating the victory over the Canaanites who had oppressed them for 20 years. Israel had a long time of peace for 40 years after that war. Are you wondering what we can learn from this story? A lot. Just like Deborah, we need to rise and shine for the Lord. Even when things don't look too good, remember, our God is a God who can use anyone to turn around the situation. Let's just be available to Him. Just like Deborah, we should be peacemakers. Instead of fighting, we can bring peace between others because Jesus is with us and He is the Prince of Peace. Just like Deborah was always bringing peace among the community, we should also bring the peace of Jesus among our friends. Just like Deborah, we need to support and help our friends when they are in need. When Barak was in need of encouragement, Deborah was always there, whether it was under the palm tree or in the battlefield. Good friends help each other even in difficult situations, because we have God's strength in us and He will strengthen us so that we can do the same for our friends. Just like Barak, we can ask for help when we need it. Asking and giving help builds friendships, and teamwork is always best. Reaching out to others who care for us builds us up. Never think twice to ask for help. Help is always there. Just like Deborah, we need to wait and depend on the wisdom from the Lord. When we have a close walk with the Lord, He will guide our every step and show us what to do when. Deborah waited on the Lord, and He opened a pathway to Israel's freedom. Just like Deborah and Barak, we have to trust and obey the Lord. The Lord might not always tell us His whole plan, but let's start by obeying what He has told us. Then eventually, He will make everything to work out for our own good, because He loves us very much. In Ecclesiastes 4:9, we see that two are better than one, because they have a good return for their work. If you have a good friend, then be thankful, because it's God's blessing for you.